Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your teacher, Hilary Sirit. Today we'll be taking you through English from 2, lesson 9. Our topic will be on writing and the subtopic will be on punctuation marks. So we'll begin with our lesson objective. I expect you as a learner by the end of the lesson will be able to define a punctuation and describe the different types of punctuation marks that we have English. So we'll begin with defining or looking at those elements in a punctuation mark. You can say punctuation marks are elements used in sentences to make sentences have sense, especially when pausing. They include the quotation marks, the apostrophe, the hyphen. Those are the first three we'll look at. So we'll begin with the quotation marks. You can see even the marks itself as being indicated there. The primary function of quotation marks is to set off and represent exact language, either spoken or written, that has come from somebody else. The quotation mark is also used to designate speech acts in fiction and sometimes poetry. Since you will often use them when working with outside sources. Successful use of quotation marks is a practical defense against accidental plagiarism and an excellent practice in academic honesty. So we can look at the uses of quotation marks. You can say they are used to indicate the actual spoken word. Example, please don't kill him, pleaded the officer. That's the first example. You quote the actual words of any speaker. Number two, they're used when referring to titles of articles, short stories, and poems. For example, I read Francis Imbuga's play, The Successor. Number three, quotation marks are used to indicate words which are foreign or are not part of standard English. Example, I ate Irio last night. Irio is not an English word, and so when we trying to indicate any foreign word, we quote them properly. We punctuate them properly. Number four, quotation marks are used to indicate a word which is not part of the sentence. Example, the concept equity has not been fully understood. Now, when we look at the apostrophe, it is used to indicate that one or several letters are missing. The apostrophe indicates a possessive in a singular noun. Example, the cafe's menu. If you look at that, you can see it. But when the possessor is a regular plural, the apostrophe follows the S. That is, you can say, the cafe's menu. Unlike the first one, the cafe's menu, the second one, we put the apostrophe after the S to show that the possessor is a regular pronoun. We can also say apostrophe indicates time or quantity. 2 weeks notice. The cafe will be open in 2 months' time. You can see it shows the time. The apostrophe also indicates the omission of figures and dates. Example, batch 8 is so excited to graduate. We can see the omission of figures and dates. Number four, apostrophe is used to indicate the omission of letters. Example, the government is set to battle the insurgents in Barcelona. If we see, we've omitted some other letters in writing of the word government. We can also look at another example. It's your turn. If we look at the words in bracket, we have omitted the word it is. It's been several years. Instead of saying, it has been several years. Number six, the apostrophe indicates plural of words, the do's and don'ts of speaking. She didn't welcome his buts and ends. We can look at the hyphen as another example, punctuation mark. So we can say it is a short line used to join two or more words into one. Uses of hyphen. Hyphen is used in compound words. What are these examples of compound words? We have words such as ball pen, mother-in-law, brother-in-law. Hyphen also is used to join two or more words used as a single adjective and preceding a noun. Example, your ideas are out of date. Mary was a happy-go-lucky man. You can say the hyphen is used to separate the words of compound number. Example, my brother turned 36 yesterday. Another use of hyphen is used to separate identical consonants or vowels in a word. Example, she coordinates other work. Other example, do not preempt what I'm about to say. Having said that, you can check on the assignment. Use the appropriate punctuation mark in the following sentences. Look at the assignment, punctuate where necessary. As you can see the assignment, if the first one, Harrison won in the by-election, is the word a compound word? Is it a single word? Is it in its regular plural or whatsoever? Try to punctuate them correctly. You can also refer much on punctuation to our Excelling in English Students Book 2, Second Edition, which is published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. For much more, you can still contact us on our SMS line as posted over there, YouTube Elimu TV, Facebook Elimu TV, Twitter @Elimu_TV_KE. Thank you for the lesson. Till next time.